Amid the deep troublemaking coronavirus crisis, the world of defense goes on. What did draw your particular attention on our different websites these last days? Well, let's focus on the so many interesting topics as usual. Don't forget to subscribe, turn on the notifications button, and enjoy the video. Russia's Advanced Research Foundation is progressing with the testing of its unmanned ground vehicles at the edge of current robotics mastery. Unveiled in December 2019, the Marker robot is a platform for exploring new military robotics technologies. Marker has also demonstrated its capability to launch a group of small reconnaissance unmanned aerial vehicles to perform tasks individually or together as a group via a cluster launch module. The Marker combat platform will indeed be optionally equipped with kamikaze type drones. These are explosive laden drones that destroy targets by crashing into them. The Marker automatically launches a large number of drones. Each one can operate alone or in a group. Marker is designed to be modular with an open information architecture. One configuration for the testbed arms it with a Kalashnikov machine gun and anti-tank grenade launchers. More armaments combination may be expected to be tested. What deserves to be observed in the video is the way the turret on the robot tracks a target with the rifle carried by the infantryman. The Marker is designed to work a pair with a fighter, receiving target designation from the side of his weapon, or be controlled remotely. So the Marker would shoot only after the accompanying infantryman has validated the target, but it could operate autonomously if programmed to do so. The Land Systems Division of the Singaporean company ST Engineering Group secured a Phase 2 contract for the production and supply of the Hunter Armored Fighting Vehicle from the Singapore Ministry of Defense. Under the contract, ST Engineering will also provide integrated logistics support, which includes spares, training and documentation. The Hunter is a tracked armored fighting vehicle jointly designed and developed by the Defense Science and Technology Agency in collaboration with ST Engineering and the Singapore Army. The Hunter tracked armored fighting vehicle was commissioned by the Singapore Army in June 2019. The Hunter AFV is the first fully digitalized armored vehicle. It integrates a combat cockpit featuring a range of multifunction displays that supports each crew member in the task of command and control, gunnery and vehicle maneuver. These display features include video and data inputs from the driving cameras, commanders and gunners' sights, all-round surveillance sensors, system data from platform sensors, and the integrated battlefield management system. Inner Mongolia First Machinery Group Company, a subsidiary of China North Industries Group Corporation, or Norinco, is reportedly starting to deliver new VT-4 main battle tanks to Pakistan, which should receive at least 100 units. In mid-April 2020, at the Chinese tank factory located in Baotou, Inner Mongolia Province, the ceremony of shipping the first batch of VT-4 main battle tanks fitted with explosive reactive armor to a foreign customer, obviously believed to be Pakistan, took place. In 2019, this country had selected the VT-4 tank in the framework of the acquisition program of at least 100 new main battle tanks. The MBT-3000, also named VT-4 for the export version, is a new generation of main battle tank designed and manufactured by Norinco. According to this company, the MBT-3000 benefits from the latest technology for main battle tanks specially designed to meet the challenge of high-tech warfare. Its overall performance and combat capability put this tank among the most advanced ones in the world. The Polish Defense Ministry has concluded negotiation regarding the purchase of FGM-148 Javelin anti-tank guided missiles. A formal agreement to this effect will be signed soon. The prime contractors are Raytheon and Lockheed Martin in a Javelin joint venture. We have concluded negotiation concerning the purchase of 60 launch units and 180 Javelin missiles, Defense Minister Mariusz Blaszczak wrote on Twitter. adding that this would not be an end of purchases. There will be more Javelins. The government of Poland had sent a request to US government to buy 180 Javelin missiles and 79 Javelin Common Launch Units. Also included were basic skill trainers, missile simulation rounds, battery coolant units, toolkits, modified two-level maintenance parts, training, US government and contractor technical assistance, transportation, and other related elements of logistics support. The total estimated program cost is $100 million. For the first time since arriving in the South Atlantic, HMS 4th crossed 850 miles of icy ocean to patrol the waters around South Georgia. The distant archipelago forms part of the territory 2000-ton 4th, which arrived in the Falklands at the turn of the year as the island's new patrol ship must reassure and ultimately protect. The Falklands patrol ship spends the majority of her time around the namesake islands, but several times a year it heads to South Georgia for a mix of military training, providing support to the island authorities and British Antarctic Survey scientists. HMS 4th is a Batch 2 River-class offshore patrol vessel in active service with the Royal Navy. Named after the River Forth, she is the first Batch 2 River-class vessel to be built. She was commissioned into the Royal Navy on the 13 April 2018, following a commissioning ceremony at the home port HMNB Portsmouth. As of January 2020, she replaced HMS Clyde as the Falklands patrol ship. In terms of specification, the HMS Force has a full load displacement of 2,000 tons, with a total length of 90.5 meters, a beam of 13 meters and a draught of 3.8 meters. The ship can reach a cruising speed of 24 knots and offers a range of 5,500 nautical miles. On April 15, 2020, the ceremony of transferring the Chilean Navy to the frigates FFG-05 Melbourne and FFG-06 Newcastle type Adelaida from the Australian fleet took place at the Australian Naval Base Watson in Sydney. Both ships were purchased under the Puente 4 program to replace the Chilean fleets of the two former Dutch frigates of the Jacob van Heemskerk type, Type L, built in the mid-1980s, purchased by Chile in 2005, and included in the Chilean Navy under the same names and airborne numbers FFG-14 Almirante La Torre and FFG Pratt 11 Captain both. Both of them were withdrawn from the Chilean fleet in December 2019. The date of arrival of purchased frigates from Australia to Chile is still unknown. Since on March 31st, coronavirus was detected in 15 Chilean crews arriving in Australia, and now Watson's base is closed for quarantine. Characteristically, the transfer of frigates did not find any reflection on the official resources of the Chilean Navy. The US Department of Defense is to award Northrop Grumman a sole source contract to supply the Royal Australian Air Force with two more MQ-4C Triton high altitude, long endurance, unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs. A notification posted on the US government's website on 14 April noted that Australia is to add to the one Triton UAV for which a contract has already been placed by exercising its options for two more as part of a wider US procurement plan. The Royal Australian Air Force plans to field a total of six such UAVs. The first MQ-4C is expected to enter service in mid-2023, with all six scheduled to be fully operational by late 2025. They will be based at RAAF base Edinburgh in South Australia. The total value of the program is expected to be about $5 billion. This contract modification establishes two unfunded option lines for five additional MQ-4C unmanned aircraft, three for the USN and two for the RAF, and two additional main operating bases, and related production support to include but not limited to the procurement of a long lead material and associated efforts, system engineering, production management, integrated logistics support, and associated technical, administrative, and financial data, the notification stated. Seven Tritons will be based at RAF Base Edinburgh and will operate alongside the Boeing P-8A Poseidon multi-mission maritime patrol aircraft. The endurance of the Triton means that it can stay airborne for longer than a traditional aircraft. The Triton builds on elements of the Global Oak UAS with reinforcement to the airframe and wing. It also has de-icing and lightning protection systems, which allow it to descend through cloud layers and gain a closer view of ships and other targets at sea, which complements the Boeing P-8A Poseidon. The Triton platform has been under development by the United States Navy since 2008. Germany plans to buy 93 Eurofighters and 45 US-made F-18s to replace aging combat jets, Stephen said on April 21st, emphasizing that the US plan satisfies NATO requirements. Amid growing criticism over her decision to include US-made aircraft in the mix, the minister said that the F-80s were needed as bridging technology. In a letter to the Parliament's Defence Committee, the minister underscored that the Boeing-built jets would allow Germany to meet its NATO nuclear sharing duties, and as they can carry US atomic warheads. At present, the Tornado is the only German Air Force plane certified to carry nuclear arms. The minister stressed, however, that Eurofighters would be the backbone of the German Air Force. Airbus has achieved the first ever fully automatic air-to-air refueling operation with a boom system. The flight test campaign conducted earlier in the year over the Atlantic Ocean involved an Airbus tanker test aircraft equipped with the Airbus A3R solution, with an F-16 fighter aircraft or the Portuguese Air Force acting as a receiver. This milestone is a part of the industrialization phase of A3R systems ahead of its implementation in the 3A330 MRTT tanker development. The campaign achieved a total of 45 flight test hours and 120 dry contacts with the A3R system, covering the whole aerial refueling envelope, as the F-16 and MRTT consolidate the maturity and capabilities of the development at this stage. The certification phase will start in 2021. The A3R system requires no additional equipment on the receiver aircraft and is intended to reduce air refueling operator workload, improve safety and optimize the rate of the air-to-air refueling transfer in operational conditions. The goal for the A3R system is to develop technologies that will reach fully autonomous capabilities. The delivery of Hellfire rockets for Kiowa Warriors helicopters earned the Croatian Armed Force of a new heavy anti-armor warfare capability. Having received AGM-114 Hellfire missiles from the US intended for the OH-58D Kiowa Warriors helicopters of the Croatian Air Force, the Kiowas attain full operational capability. The missiles have provided a long operational range anti-tank warfare precision and multi-target capability weapon operational in both daytime and nighttime conditions, and improved safety for the crew. Hellfire missiles are sophisticated anti-tank missiles manufactured by Lockheed Martin, homing in on laser beam from the aircraft or a ground-based tripods, and capable of operating from ground, sea and air platforms, both in day and nighttime conditions. The Kiowa Warrior helicopters of the Croatian Air Force have received software upgrades for the use of Hellfire missiles, and the pilots have undergone conversion training previously using drill missiles. Well, keep in mind that Defense Web TV has more than 1,400 videos on its YouTube channel. So please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell here under to be informed of the latest defense and security news.